Hello, Mr. Eric, Mr. Ryan, how are you today?
Yeah, good.
Today we're going to talk about univalue tree, binary tree. So what's univalue? Like that. Binary tree. Yeah, what's binary tree? What's binary tree, by the way?
Is a tree with numbers.
Okay, so how many kids?
Numbers.
How many maximum?
The maximum of the kids is one parent.
One parent, but two kids maximum, yeah. Right? Two kids, because this binary is two. Look, this parent, let's call so called root, has maximum two kids, but this one only has one, right? This one only has one, and this one has none. When a kid has no...
It's called a leaf.
Leaf, and when a kid has no parent, it's called...
It's called...
What is it called?
Root.
Yes, right now. Okay, so look, these values, all the nodes has a value 1, yeah? Yeah?
Why?
No, I just make it, all these nodes are the same value, so it's called univalue. Okay? Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Unit, what's unit? Prefix.
1.
Unique, yeah? You know the unique, yeah?
Unique means different, but they're all the same. No,
unique is the same, not different. Yeah? You and Ryan are unique, means you are different. Right? Alright? Yeah? What did I say? Yes. Yeah? Yeah, it's unique, right? Means one is unique, right? Alright? Does it make sense? Unique value means only single value, right? Got it? Does it make sense?
What happens all of them are two?
That's okay, let's steal univalue because there's only one value, right? Yes, right. Is that true? Yeah, but how about look?
Yeah.
How about look? If I have another one here, so this is not univalue because it contains two, right? So today's task is no play. Today's task is given a binary tree, we want to make sure if it's a univalue binary tree. Any ideas?
And we just look it up.
Well done! Look it up, how do we look it up? We need to count how many numbers in the notebook, right? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so how can we traverse the tree? How many ways can we visit the notes in a particular order?
Breakfast search.
And?
Death
Okay, so yes, there are two. Breakfast search, death search. Of course there are more, but so far you learned these two. So how about we using the breakfast search to solve this problem? So what's breakfast search? Can you tell me?
Level by level.
Level by level. And what kind of data structure are we using to implement the breakfast search?
The notebook.
No, the notebook is used to check if there is only one value in the tree, right?
Yeah.
But when we're visiting the nodes, we use kind of data structure to implement a breakfast search. Remember, how many data structure,
Set. Tree.
And what else? The stack and...
Queue.
Yeah, are we using a queue or stack to implement a breakfast search?
Stack. No,
sorry?
Queue.
Yes, of course. Remember the queue. Remember. Let's do this breakfast search. Visit this breakfast search, so we know you don't forget it. Okay. Look. Okay. Look. We want to visit the breakfast search in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 order. Okay. So we have a queue, right? First in, first out, right?
That's definitely not unique.
I know it's not unique value. Look, one. I put it in the queue. We call it in queue. Yeah. One. Yeah. Okay.
Next one, two.
No, next one, at the beginning, the queue is initialized with the root, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then now we need to check if the queue is empty. If it's not empty, we keep doing this, okay? If the queue is not empty, why queue not empty, yeah? Not empty. Okay? Then we do this. P equals Q dot pop left. Okay, so we take this out. What's the kit of one and one? What's the children of one?
2 and 3.
Okay, now we put it here. 2 and 3. Okay, got it? Yeah? Yeah. Okay, now we...
They're not the same.
Look, we take the cow and then we push its kid, yeah? Push kid P dot left, if not empty, to the queue, yeah? If not empty. Push P dot right, if not empty, to the queue, okay? Now, what's the next item to take it out from the queue?
2. 2.
Take it out.
And put
what?
4 and 5.
Well done! Wow! Because it's kid, yeah? 4 and 5. Okay, so next, while the queue is not empty, what's the next to take out?
3.
Okay, and what's its kid?
6 and 7.
Well done. Okay, look, you see? 4, take it out. It doesn't have a kid, yeah? So we don't care. 5, take it out. It doesn't have a kid, yeah? Take it out.
We don't care.
6 and 7. Again, right? Look, and now it's empty, right? Look, yeah? So the order we visit is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Got it? This is called breakfast search, am I right? Does it make sense? Yeah?
Yeah.
You learned this before, yeah? Right?
I know.
Yeah, I know, yeah, good. Okay, so now let's do this. And then that's it. Okay, today will be quick. Define unit value.
Yeah.
Root. Okay, what's missing?
Column, okay. Always.
Not always, sometimes it's cash. Huh? but this time you're right, it's column. If
yeah.
Root is noun, if the root is noun, we return what? Yeah? If the root is noun, does it have a unit? 2, yeah. We obvious, maybe you can return false, but we return 2 in this case to define.
Right?
That's okay, you need to understand. Because this root, empty root, empty tree.
Broken.
Empty tree is
with
a.
Me.
Okay, empty tree is a special case, which is, ooh, we define it as a unit value. Okay, now look. Q, we use the DQ, yeah? What's DQ? What's D stand
double
for?
Q.
Double N D Q.
I was about to say that.
Okay, and now what should I put here? Initialize as what? Remember, what did I say at the beginning?
Root.
Well done. Yeah, remember we take that back. Okay? And wire. Wire what? Wire what? Wire what? Eric.
Wire.
Wire what?
Wire.
Look at this wire what? Wire. The length of the queue is what?
Length of the queue
is what?
Is
what?
Not none.
Not zero. It's bigger than zero or non-zero. Because that means that if there are items in the queue, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Then we take one from the queue. Q dot what?
Q dot, I think.
What? Q dot what?
Pop.
Pop, but because we are using DQ, we need to specify pop left. Yeah, we're done. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay, look, we forgot a notebook. Yeah, we need to put this in the notebook. Put a notebook equal set. Okay, we use a set. Okay, notebook here. Look, and then we got notebook dot at this number, right? P dot value. Okay. And then look, if currently if there are more than one element in the notebook, we should return true or false. If
false,
well done. Yeah? Bigger than one. Because if you found already 2 numbers in a notebook, it means it's not
I
unit value.
Guess.
Yeah? But you guess right. Good job. Okay? Return false, right? Yeah?
You're supposed to understand, man.
But do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay,
man.
Okay, look, now what's the next? If P dot left, what should we do? If there's kid of the left side, what should we do?
Kids on the left side.
You take it out from the queue, and then what should we do? Remember, we take one out, what should we do next? We need to, the kid is not empty, what should we do?
If the kid is not empty, return what?
No, we need to,
pop.
No?
A pen.
Yeah, we need to put the kids in that, right?
Yeah.
Then what? Q dot
a pen.
A pen what? A pen what? And if P dot right, a pen what?
Up and away.
Huh?
A pen left, right.
P dot left. And what's a pen here?
P dot right.
And return what here?
True. I guess.
Yes, because after list it's a univalue. After we travel, the binary tree using binary processors. Does it make sense? What's the time complexity?
O1. Yeah.
Yeah. What's the space complexity?
O1.
You say O1. You say what?
N. I don't know actually.
Are we using a notebook?
Yeah. No.
Actually,
O1. Sorry.
N. O-N, I think.
Okay. So.
One of them
is right. We use a notebook. We didn't use a stack. We use a queue, right?
Oh yeah, queue.
Yeah.
It's a type of data structure.
Yeah, it's O-N. Yeah, because we are using a queue, and then queue in the worst case you could contain the linear number of the nodes. Yeah. Look, if it's a full binary tree, it's a full binary tree. Yeah, that's 4. Yeah? Around n divided by 2, right? So it's O(n). If we are not considering the queue as additional storage, what's the space complexity?
A1.
Very slow.
Oh, no, I mean space complexity if we're not counting the queue as additional storage.
O1.
O1. Why is O1?
Because we're not using a data structure.
But look, there's a notebook here.
O1 content for the notebook. So it's O1.
N.
O-N? You O-N? We're not using notebook and you say?
A1 because
what?
O1 is for
Are we using notebook?
We are using notebook. Is it O1 or O-N?
O-1.
N.
1.
N.
1.
We are using the notebook. Is it O1 or O-N?
A1.
Why is O1?
Because A1 content is about the notebook.
No, it's a lookup, but I mean the space complexity, not the time complexity. Space complexity. Is it O1 or O-N?
A1.
Is it the O1?
Love A1.
You love O1. Normally using a notebook is the space complexity is O-N, but in this case it's O1. Can you tell me why?
Why?
Because look. If it contains more than one number, we just return immediately, am I right?
Yeah.
So, what's in the worst case? In the worst case, how many numbers can be stored in a hash table, in a notebook?
I don't know.
I just said...
N.
Why is it
one.
N? 2, actually. If it's more than 1, then we return, alright?
Yeah.
So how many... In the worst case, there are how many numbers can be in the notebook?
Lots.
Come on, I just said if the notebook contains more than one number, you will return the function immediately. So what's the maximum number of numbers can be held in this case, I'm saying?
Zero.
Why is this one? If it's more than one, what's the biggest number? What's the smallest number that biggest than one? Bigger than one?
One.
What's the...
Two.
Two, yes. If it's two number, then we return. So what's the maximum? What's the worst case? The space complexity for a notebook? 2, right? So if it's 2, then it's O1 constant, am I right? Does it make sense? Yeah?
Yeah.
If I don't have list, if I remove list, and then what should I do here? Return length of notebook equals what?
Equals
what? What's the univalue? How many numbers should be in a notebook?
N, 2.
No, univalue, 1. Come on, we are adding it to the notebook.
N.
Look, you see the difference. If we don't have that if check, we don't have if check. We need to check it at the end when we finish the BFS, right? And we need to check how many numbers in the notebook. 1, because let's make it univalue, right? If we don't check, we return 2 here. But when we're adding an element to the notebook, when it's more than 2, more than 1, it means it's not univalue. Then we can just immediately return, right? We'll keep doing that, right? There'll be early exit, early exit. Because we find out it's not a univalue. We already find out there are 2 different numbers. Do we need to continue checking the rest of the notes?
No.
Yes. Of course, no, right? Does it make sense?
Yeah.
And if we have another if check, that means that at most, the notebook has two numbers, right? So we optimize the space complexity. Am I right? Does it make sense? Okay, so can you write this? Can you write this? If what? If what? If what? What?
If.
Yeah?
Length.
Length, yes? Length what? What length? What length? Length of what? We want to check.
Notebook.
Notebook, yes. Notebook what?
Bigger than one.
Bigger than one. Voila. What?
Column.
Yeah, and what?
Return.
I
think false.
Come on, be confident, not I think. Okay? You're doing a good job, okay? Okay, that's it for today. That's it.
Bye.
Bye bye. See you tomorrow. Have fun.
Bye
bye. Hello. Hello.
New.
Hello. Okay, that's it.